got to change your physiology. You got to change your breath. You got to change your voice. You got to make that change. If you just try to take massive action in a low state, it won't happen. But once it's there, once you're trained to take action, you're going to get momentum. Because what if, a lot of people say, but what if I take the wrong action? Well, better take the wrong direction and go full tilt, because you'll find out it's not working and you can change it. But if you sit there at the crossroads, I don't know what to do, I don't want to make a mistake, then you've already made the biggest mistake of all. I am never leaving the site of a decision without doing something in that moment that guarantees I have to follow through later on. Momentum comes from massive action. So you got to make the phone call and hire the coach.
And here's the cool part. You can apply to work with Tony's coaches.
Please welcome Disturbed!
Darkness, my old friend, I've come to talk with you again, because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was sleeping, and the vision that was planted in my brain still remains. When the sound of silence, in restless dreams I walked alone, narrow streets of cobblestone, beneath the halo of a street lamp, I turned my collar to cold and damp. When my eyes were stared by the flash of a neon light, it split in the night and touched the sound of silence. And in the naked light I saw 10,000 people, maybe more. People talking without speaking. People hearing without listening. People writing songs and voices never shared. No one dared disturb the sound of silence. For said I, you do not know. Silence like a castle grows. Hear my words and I might teach you. Take my arms and I might reach you. Thank you.
Hey guys, how's everybody doing today? I hope you're having fun. I hope you have some fun coming your way shortly. I don't see Star Mama here, but I just checked the email and she said that, and she had sent these a little bit earlier too, which I'm thankful for because I still don't have the Chrome thing set up. So the really cool announcement is that Star Mama is launching her own channel. Yes! She is launching her cooking channel. I'm telling you, she will become the next Rachel Ray. She has uploaded two videos so far. And then it sounds like it's going to be a day or two before she's actually able to go live. So when she gets here, she can hop up on the panel and she can explain stuff to you. And then the videos will be up there for keeps, which is even nicer, really, because the videos will be specifically focused on the recipe. Yay, here she is. Okay. Paste. I just hope she remembers us when she's rich and famous, you know? I'm thinking she will. We'll just make sure she doesn't forget us. We'll just bug her all the time. Star Mama. Did it work? Maybe it didn't work. Here she is. Okay. So, ready?
Yep.
Hey, Star Mama. Oops.
Hey, that's okay. I said I'd show my face. I don't have a problem with that.
Look at you, darling.
I don't know about how darling, but I'm here anyway. So, how's everybody doing? Hope everybody's having a good day.
Yeah, we just got here like 2 minutes. 2 minutes yeah. Before you. So,
what it is with YouTube, I have to have 50 subs and then wait, apply to YouTube, and it takes 24 hours for them to process to say yay or nay on your channel. So I didn't have the 32 subs, and I didn't even know I had them, actually. So when I get those, then I can request to go live. That's to go live. That's to go live.
Okay, so you need 50 subscribers to be able to apply to YouTube to be able to have a live stream.
On YouTube. And okay. Actually, before I can post like pictures like that cake or the roast, I have to have a community page, which I have to have 1,000 subs. So that's some ways down the road. But nevertheless, if I can't do it here, I'm going to try to see how I can go through StreamYard and maybe go live through StreamYard like we are right now and bypass YouTube. This is all very new to me, and it's, you know, you have to figure everything out, you know.
With StreamYard, they want you to be able to put a YouTube channel that you click on. Mm-hmm. So you may have to already be approved on YouTube to do it. I don't know.
That's what I'm thinking. It's probably all interlinked together. Yeah.
What we need to do is we need how many people? 16 people to head over there quick.
Right. But I mean, it's still going to be 24 hours before, you know, they can approve me. And I haven't been in trouble with YouTube in the past 90 days because I don't have a channel. So there shouldn't be any problems with it. And let me see. Anyway, the meatloaf and the potato salad videos up. I'm going to try to figure out where I want to go from here. Maybe some ideas from everybody. I want to do the piccata chicken and stick with some of the crock pot recipes. But I thought because of the 4th of July weekend, I would do the meatloaf and potato salad. And then I'll go back to doing that. So maybe if I can go live, I'm getting a tripod too. So my camera, you know, it'll hold my phone and I can move it around. It'll be here Saturday. I've already ordered it. So
nice.
trying to get on top of this.
You're totally taken up. I am so glad, Sir Mama. I am so glad. It's like, this is fun. We get to kind of live vicariously through you as you do this.
Right. It is fun, and I'm going to enjoy doing it. You know, it's going to give me something to look forward to. And if I can help people save money doing some crock pot recipes and teaching them how to cook from scratch. And actually, yes. Scratch cooking is just a matter of tasting as you go along. And you really are just guessing at how much you start out with small amounts. You add smaller amounts, and you taste it until it gets to where you, which the way you want it to be, you know. And everybody's different about their likes and their taste. So with the potato salad.
You know, it's a little bit of a challenge. It's, I think, a lot more difficult to teach other people how to cook from a distance, you know?
Right. It is. And especially, I was scared on there because I didn't know what I was doing. So,
well, you did a really good job on the one that I watched. And I love your refrigerator. Oh, my gosh. Well, let me see your nails. I got to see your nails.
My nails? Oh, yeah. They're right here.
Look at those. Ladies, those nails are not.
Those are mine. Yeah, they're mine. Yeah, I'll show you the other side. They're my nails. Yeah, you can see the different lengths and stuff. Yeah,
good for mine. You. Good for you.
Yeah, they're mine. I've learned to cook and get around using them like that. I don't let them get usually any longer than this. I just haven't bothered to cut them down and redo them because my arms get my hands. I've got arthritis, as y'all can see in my hands. And sometimes it's kind of hard for you to get those fingers working the way you want them to, you know. Yeah. What I'm talking about. Yeah. And then with my shoulder on top of that, it's been acting up a little bit. So that's on my right side. I'm right-handed. So yeah, you kind of just have to play that by ear, what you can do.
I think the channel will be a really good thing for you to kind of work through the pain and maneuver and have something else to focus, you know, some of your energy on. Not that you don't already have enough to focus on, but.
Right. Well, you know, I enjoy doing it, and I've thought about it for a long time, so we'll see.
Yeah, I think the world needs it right now, Star Mama. I do, because, again, the prices are high, and, you know, there are babies to feed. So, right. Okay, Bonita just subscribed. Let's see here. Tabitha says that you're up to 41 subs, okay.
Okay, that's good. And I did ask Mia to share the link too, because she had people over there that said they would sub to me if I put a channel up where they could watch.
Good, good. Okay, and Caitlin just subscribed. Lucy subscribed.
Thanks, guys. I appreciate it.
Okay, somebody check in where I can check, I think. Let me see here.
And I mean, the videos are up. They can go over there and play them and watch them anytime they want. And they can watch them as many times as they want.
And I think that's really smart too, because that way people can actually play them while they're actually physically clicking, you know?
Right. And since I'm guessing at what I'm using, the measurement, but it's going to teach them how to use their taste buds.
Mm-hmm. You're 50 right now. Sorry.
I am 50. Oh, good. Yeah. Okay, yeah, so great.
Right now, well, so you're ready to go ahead and
then I can get a hold of YouTube and say, let's party.
Exactly. Yeah. Yay.
That's good. I appreciate it, guys. I really do. Thank you so much. I do. I appreciate that.
So that'll be the next step then, is then after they say yes, then you're able to
go live.
Go ahead and do live chats, which is huge. And mm-hmm. then once you start doing live chats, you're going to be up to that 1,000 before you know it.
I hope so. That kind of be nice, just so I could go on a community post and post things, items that they would need for a recipe, to where they can go back and look at that, you know, instead of a play whole video to figure it out. That would help a lot. It really would.
And they can print it off and everything too, and, you know, copy it, print it off, whatever.
Mm-hmm. Right. Hey, I was going to tell you, I did go over and listen to you on ADs. You did good. You did a great job.
I'll tell you, I was a nervous wreck. Because
I could tell a little bit.
You could tell my voice, right? Because I couldn't hear him very well at all. So it was just like when I was trying to be able to hear Mia last night. I was kind of sitting with my face like up by my screen, almost not that close, but trying to hear. And there was like a time delay too. I don't know if you heard my computer, but it was kind of like a couple times. So it was weird. It was just weird. And yeah, I felt nervous about it because I thought, ugh.
Well, his accent is a little hard to get used to. Once you do, you can pretty well understand him. But he does have a strong accent. He really does.
Well, somebody said something about a comment that he made, and I thought, I don't remember him saying that. they emailed, and you know, and it was a concerning situation. They were talking about how her name is Chicken Lady.
Oh, yeah. She's been very sick. I knew that. Yeah. Well, I knew she'd been in and out of the hospital. I'm not sure what, but I know she'd been pretty sick. It was a pretty serious illness, and it was very touch and go for her.
That's what he was saying, and I wasn't hearing. I heard just part of it. I heard that she was sick. I didn't hear him say the word karma. I didn't hear that because of the connection and the way my computer was acting and everything.
Mm-hmm.
And so somebody emailed me. I thought, I don't remember him saying that.
Well, people were telling her to watch out. Karma would get her, you know.
Well, what he said was that when she became very ill, that's what the scumbag attackers were saying, is that karma got her.
Yes.
That is absolutely disgusting.
The reason why she calls herself Chicken Lady is because she raises chickens.
Well, cool. Yeah, I kind of wondered.
They're her babies. They are her babies. She has them named and everything. Yes.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm not familiar with any of that at all. So, yeah, I kind of wondered. The name Chicken Lady was kind of different. But
I just know from just seeing occasional stuff that was posted. And, and then I had heard where she was sick. And he had two or three of them that was kind of sick at the same time. And I thought, wow, you know.
So that was kind of hard when I'm thinking, what else did I miss? And what, mm-hmm. like, did I answer something that I thought was a whole different thing? You know what I mean?
Well, you did. I think you did very well. You know, I do hate that you've already got, you and AD have got people coming for you from another.
Within 3 or 4 hours, they were posting smack.
Yeah. Well, this is from another creator. That's saying that you all are blaming Junior and you shouldn't be, and that he's on to both of you and he's going to fit, MD, who I'm talking about, the dude over there that has so much information and never produced it on Avocado's channel. Remember?
You mean the one that posted those comments? I went ahead and posted a reply to those because that's mm-hmm. just wrong.
Yeah. He said that he listed the people that y'all should be blaming on certain creators' channels, and he's not even listing himself. And if he thinks that Junior's exempt from that, he's certainly not, because he was the one that instigated telling people to call people over and over again and hang up on them until they were forced to change their phone number. And he said, oh, he did that because he's just in a bad state of mind. That's still no excuse. He should never. He was inciting people to make threats and bully people and harass people.
And I think a lot of times, too, the creators who talk about that situation, they like to present it as if he only did that after years and years of being whatever.
No, he did that from the beginning.
He did that right in 2018. So
yeah, because Set the Record had that, posted that in his videos.
Exactly.
And he did not take it down the next day, like he said. I took it down within 24 hours. No, you did. He did not do that. So
Bell Pepper Green is on backstage, but it says devices not connected, Bell Pepper. So I don't know what that's about. But I can't click on it because it says not connected.
Oh, I don't have any idea who that is. I've never heard of him. But after last night, I'm not surprised. That one dude or whoever, they think they're really cute, don't they? But anyway, I was going to tell you, you know, regarding the case and stuff, a lot of people don't realize that people that are close to you can have different opinions than you have. My daughter, who is almost 40, we don't even discuss the case anymore because she thinks I'm wrong.
Well, and that's okay. That's what the true crime community is all about. Mm-hmm. You know, I told you how I got started on true crime was when my mom was sick. My mom thought for sure that, what's her name, Casey Anthony, that she just wanted to go party, and she chloroformed the kid and stuffed her in the trunk and went out and partied and left her there and da-da-da-da-da. I don't think so. I think it was a swimming pool accident. That's my opinion. My mother, bless her heart, thought for sure that it was the partying mama who, you know, made it happen, whatever.
Well, a lot of people, I think, come to that conclusion because of all the lies she told, you know.
Right.
She right. was a bald-faced liar. She just was.
Yeah, that whole Disney World routine and stuff, of course. But we went another 5, 6, 7, 8 years absolutely disagreeing about that case. Big flipping deal. That's what makes the conversation fun, even, is to have different opinions going at it.
Well, me and her really aren't too different, because I did get her convinced to go watch her videos, and she did finally say, yeah, Mom, she had problems. She was an abusive mother. She did come back with that. But the only thing, this is where we differ. She thinks she did kill the girls, but she thinks that he lost it when he seen that and he killed her. That's what she thinks. And she thinks she did it while she was over in the bathroom vomiting or sick on whatever, that he choked her up. Like, that's what she thinks. You know.
Almost passed out or something.
Yes.
Yeah.
But she thinks that there's a lot more people involved, and that he was set up as far as being blamed for the girls and stuff.
Right. Well, we have a lot of people right here on the channel who come to the chat who absolutely do not agree with anything that I say, right. You know, who absolutely think he's absolutely guilty, whatever, but they're adults who like true crime and they like to discuss the case.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And, you know, I like to hear people's opinions and their thoughts, you know, and maybe through showing different things, you can change people's minds. I know even with me, she'd never seen that makeup tutorial, and that she said that blew her mind. She said she knew that SW had problems, but she said she didn't realize the severity of it until she watched that. Mm-hmm. And now she's figured out that her phone didn't even ping there. I mean, she's finding out a lot of information.
That whole phone thing, because it just throws everything kind of like, what?
Yeah, it does.
It makes me wonder how many people were there at the house.
Well, I have heard people say up to 8 people, so I don't know, you know.
Yeah.
And I suppose it's possible, you know.
Was a red truck and a gray truck and a red car and a whatever car, mm-hmm. then that Nate's house would have been on the side by the garage that would have, you know, they may have seen cars and trucks coming and going.
Yeah, well, that kind of bugs me, because I just wonder why Betty didn't see him, you know, when she left earlier that morning. You would have thought she would have seen, she's seen the gray truck when she got back, but you would have thought she would have glanced over and been able to see, you know, maybe the red truck or this car or something sitting there. And she never said she did.
Didn't the red truck leave, though, when Christopher Watts left?
I don't really know. I'm not sure about that, because there's so much of that video that's been doctored and people have put stuff in there. I mean, even Maya, she even showed Mia, sorry, I don't want to call her Maya. Mia even showed where there's a plastic bag sitting out in the driveway that I had never seen before. And she said, that's because they took and they put stuff in there. And now the videos are being doctored to make people think that a lot of things are there that aren't. And that's what she thinks about the shadows also. She thinks it's all fake. And she'll tell you that.
I think so too. I don't believe in the shadow thing.
No, I don't either. And I don't what they make the big deal out about that gas can. Anyway, I don't. None of that makes sense to me.
Honey Badger was talking about that quite a bit. I think Honey Badger had a theory about that. That he was. I can't remember exactly. I think that there was talk that there was a plan at some point that he was supposed to go ahead and set something on fire. Mm-hmm. But then he didn't do it.
You know, that I don't know if people realize how many people's lives would have been involved in that. And I mean, in planning that, I mean, he couldn't do that all by himself, plan that. I just don't believe that many people were going to stick their neck out like that, try to pull something like that off. I just don't believe it. It doesn't make sense to me, you know.
I know none of this case makes sense, does it?
No, it gets kind of crazier. The further along you get, you think you're coming to a sensible conclusion, then it changes again. So
you now have 56. You're up to 56 subscribers.
Good. I'm going to need them if I'm going to do this.
And we only have 53 people in the chat right now. So hallelujah. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you, everybody. I appreciate it. I really do. I don't know if they want to go watch. The videos are only like, they want to take turns and go watch it. Videos are only 10 minutes long. And they might go in there and have questions about it. I don't know why we're talking about other things, or if they want to do it, maybe we could come on for a little bit tomorrow if they have questions, just for questions and answers, or I don't know.
I'll be able to tomorrow.
Okay.
That's probably no. I probably could for just a little bit, but I know the noise would be very loud and it would be.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. Yeah, that's probably not a good idea. But maybe they could get, if they've got a lot of questions or something, they could get them together and maybe, you know, Wednesday or so before I would actually get a chance to go live, I could maybe get an idea of what they want to talk about. You know?
Well, they can comment under the videos too, right? So they could maybe say, hey.
I think so. I believe they can. I don't know why they couldn't. I don't know.
If not, if it says there'll be a thing underneath, it'll either say zero comments and then it'll give a place to put a comment, or it'll say that they're turned off.
Right. They may not turn the comments on until I'm approved for the live chats and stuff. And that they may not do that actually until then, where you can do the comments or the live chat. I'm sure you can't, you'd have to be able to go live to have a live chat. So, yeah.
Everyone, a star moment. I'm going to go ahead and make the meatloaf next instead of the fried rice.
Yep, you can comment.
Oh, you can comment? Good. Okay.
Okay, where are you now? Let's see where.
There you are. Yeah. I think she really thought I had fake fingernails, and I thought, oh, wow. Yeah.
You know, I was teasing Star Mama. I'm like, I don't know. Manicured nails. You say
Yeah, I do. Instead of just going silent and not saying anything, I go there because I lose my train of thought. I've always done that. My daughter said, Mom, you got to quit saying that so much. And I said, I know. It's just a nervous habit.
It's human behavior. I learned in college how to not do that, because when we were presenting, our professor taught us actually that we don't have to fill every space. And so we were actually graded on it. Mm-hmm. And when you practice it a few times, then you can stop doing it. I still do it all the time. I was doing it on the AD thing last night. I caught myself a couple times.
Yeah. Yeah. But that, when you get kind of, when you're nervous, that's what happens. But you're going to go on. When are you going to go on there to do, you're going to play, are you going to play Cindy? Like he wanted you to come on here. You're going to go back and play the video. Like he asked you.
Yep, we're going to discuss the Cindy interview. Yep.
Okay. Do you know when you're going to do it?
Yeah, I think it's going to be next weekend.
Okay. Okay.
But I don't know for sure yet. I was very pleased with how he spoke and how he was focused. He stayed focused on, I think, what mattered. I think, you know, for him to promote the channel, for him to promote the project enough, and to really jump on board with it. Like, he absolutely is promoting the fact that he believes people should come forward.
Right. Well, I think they should, you know. And if enough people do, maybe that family will get the message that, you know, look, you're the ones that are talking about being harassed and bullied and threatened. Look at all this. And you're going to tell me all these people are just making this up? No. Because most people have proof. I do, and I know you certainly do. And I know there's habits.
I've showed a lot of my proof so far, and people know it.
Yes.
I thought it was hilarious. Right before I clicked on the live thing, there was a new comment on the channel. You know, somebody in their brilliance was informing everybody that Cindy video was actually from before, and that Cindy no longer speaks to me. And I just had to reply. I'm like, LOL, like old news, you know?
Right. Well, they can go there if they want to, but I honestly don't believe that certain people are talking to her either. So, you know, I just don't believe it.
Well, and the idea that she isn't speaking with me, if anyone is familiar with this case discussion, then they know exactly what went down.
Right. They do. They should.
They can go ahead and bring all their drama and whatever, but they're not going to show up on the channel and do some kind of ridiculous comment. Another one earlier today, Star Mama. Oh, couldn't believe it. The crap that's being posted, you know, the promotion of hatred and harassment this morning after, you know, there were a few comments that I went ahead and posted, and then someone showed up on the channel and said, you know, take my name off. You shouldn't be putting my name up there. That's not right. What? What?
And so I said,
yeah, I'm like, let me get this straight. So you're taking part in a hate thread, you know,
mm-hmm.
and now you want what, you know, she's like, you have no right to put my name up there. And of course she spelled right how they all spell right. R-I-T-E.
Oh gosh.
Yeah. I know. I really wish they'd learn how to spell.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's like Mia said too, even the ones that she thought were decent people and been over there and behaving, when she started showing stuff and started being more vocal, well, they want to come at her, but they misspell words. They misspell things.
Yeah.
And to me, it's just, the story's there. This has been continuous for almost 4 years. When they do this, they don't know how to write. They just
that tells me there's just a handful of people doing all the writing.
And she's on the same page about that now. And she honestly believes people are getting paid to do this.
I do too.
I kind of laughed at her because she told me, she said, I kind of think that they open the psych hospital and some of them just got through there as we were dealing with, because they make no sense with some of the stuff they want to say. And just like all that crap last night at the live, I mean, what was that about?
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. And then another channel.
Distraction. It's a distraction is what it is. That's all it is.
Exactly right. And another channel today posted a video. I didn't watch the video, but I saw the comments. A few of the comments were sent to me. And two of the relatives are in there posting. And one of them posted that he is a sick man, referring to AD.
Oh, yeah.
And they were complaining about him because he was talking about the nut meltdown.
Mm-hmm.
And he said something about the peanut allergy and the peanut butter in the closet.
Yes.
And so they're mocking him because evidently, you know, they think he's too dumb to know that the peanuts aren't tree nuts, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I went ahead and posted that little paragraph from Discovery. Because you know how much they like the facts, right?
Oh, yeah.
So I went ahead and posted that up on the community page that shows where it was right in Discovery that Christopher Watt's wife had to explain to his mother all about the serious peanut allergies.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they try to act like we're just pulling stuff out of thin air for fun or something. No.
But the thing about it is, you know, she even said that they went through a lot of peanut butter in the house. And even when she went shopping, wherever she was in that one cart that she was pushing around, she had a big container of it in there too.
Exactly.
And I mean,
so what they're doing is they're trying to change the story now, evidently, when they put these comment threads out there and these videos out there to make it sound like we're the ones. And I say we, as in anyone discussing this case, but especially AD, that's who they were slamming, that we're the ones who are making this stuff up just for clicks and views or something. And no, we're not making this stuff up. It was right in the Discovery that the girls were allergic to peanuts.
Mm-hmm.
It was also stated they were allergic to tree nuts.
Mm-hmm. And a chocolate. Yes.
And a chocolate and a kiwi and to eggs.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, actually, I went back and looked at one video where, you know, remember where she bathed Cece and then took her to the hospital. She's broke out all of her back. And I know CW was holding her. And even in that video, they said they wasn't sure if it was from the kiwi or from the nuts. They weren't sure. So I don't know how you almost have to have allergy tests done on kids. And you would have thought she would have posted that, you know.
They posted a picture of, it looks like Bella, who had like three big welts on her back that were supposedly a reaction from an allergy test.
Yeah, that too. Yeah. But what about, I thought Cece was the one that was allergic to the tree nuts.
I thought so too.
And processed foods, that's what she said. I thought that was Bella he was holding. I didn't think, but she kept saying, referring to Cece and stuff. And I thought, it doesn't make sense, you know?
Well, evidently both girls were allergic to peanuts, according to the Discovery.
Yeah. Well, again, they should never have been given those Pro Bars because it says they were processed food that were made in a factory where tree nuts are So, I mean, I don't get, especially in those lemon meringue ones.
If you have children with serious allergies, you're not giving them any kind of processed stuff that you don't know what's in them.
Right.
And because it's a nutritional supplement or whatever, they do not have to release everything that's in them.
Right. I think the whole thing with Cindy Watts, that meltdown thing that happened with the nut thing, I think that was just a way for her last attempt to discredit her, because she, that was the last strike she had to go after CW with, as far as cutting that tie off with the family. And I think that's what that was all about. I don't think that it really amounted to what,
something to that, but I also think that she wasn't really in control. I think she was facing the end.
And
I think she was losing control. I think she was so, like, getting on the plane and going there, I think she felt all like, ooh, you know, and telling the hairstylist that she was getting divorced and everything. And I think you're right about the 10 grand too, by the way. So maybe she felt, maybe she felt rich there for a second, right?
Right. And, you know, how do we, how does anybody know she didn't actually put that, maybe she went under a different name, and maybe she put money down on a place, a deposit, because look, she used several different names anyway. She may have done that and just lost that because she never went back. You don't really know, you know, what
nobody
she did.
Knows. Yeah. Nobody knows. Or it could have been handed over to somebody else to handle for her.
It could have been that. And I wondered about that too. And I wondered if the $30 that she was given didn't come out of that, actually.
Seriously, yeah. I cannot come up with any reasonable explanation for somebody to give her $30 in cash. Unless it was an allowance.
Or just that she, because, that is kind of strange, because she did have, I think it was either $1,300 or $1,600 in the bank, so she could have easily have got money from there. If she needed $30, I would have bought.
Right. Yeah, if she needed to pay for cab fare or something.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So people.
Yeah, and then to give it to her on the plane, yeah, that is kind of crazy, yeah.
Here, take a look at this. You look very classy, Star Mama. No, you do. You do.
Well, thanks, everybody. I appreciate it. I try. You know, people think just because you get older, you don't need to worry about your appearances or take care of yourself or your skin. You really do need to do that. You know, focus on that.
I have to admit, I got a pedicure on Friday.
And, did you?
Oh, I tell you. You know, if you've enjoyed getting pedicures, then you know what I'm saying.
Yeah. Because
they're, you know, out of the 65 minutes, there were about 15 minutes there where I was just like, oh, that feels good, you know?
Yeah.
Very relaxing.
They feel better afterwards too, you know.
Exactly. I look at my toes, I've got beautiful, it's almost like a deep wine color. Mm-hmm. And it's just, you know, because I've got black hair, so it's, the deep wine is in my color scheme. And I look at my toes and I just go, ooh, beautiful.
Yeah.
It sounds silly, but it matters.
Oh, but I go get them quite often too. I was getting them once a month there for a while. And then with the epidemic and all that stuff that came up,
the pandemic kind of changed everything up. Yeah. Exactly. Mm-hmm. Do you mind my asking what you pay for a pedicure?
Well, the shop I go to, I had went there from the time my daughter is turning 40. She got her, they did her nails for her prom when she graduated from high school.
You are?
And I went there, I've been going there ever since. And they used to do, when I had the, not the acrylic nails, but the gel nails. I went there and always got them done. They only charged me $25, that's all they charged me.
Are you kidding me?
No, I'm not kidding you. That's all I pay. They used to do it in those little heated tub things, you know, while they were doing your nails. But when I quit getting my nails done, I started going to the chairs, and it went from $18 to $20. And I just put a $5 tip on there because it's $20. That's what I paid. I paid that 4 months ago when I had one done. So,
4 months ago.
And I never paid over. It was like $46 for me to get my nails to get a refill, which was the gel where they, and they put it over my own nails anyway. I didn't have the fake nails on. I tried those acrylic nails for about 6 months and they just irritated me, so I didn't use them. And I would pay $45 for that and the pedicure then. So, yeah. I heard a lot of people say they're very expensive other places, but yeah.
$55.
Oh, really? For just, yeah. Oh, wow.
And when she said it, I kind of thought, what?
Did yeah, she that's say, kind of steep.
Or, you know, I mean, $35 I would have figured would have been right in mm-hmm. in the ballpark. And she said $55. I'm like, what? $55?
And I wonder, are they going up because they're having to allow for their gas expense and everything now, going back and forth to work? And
I don't know
if their supplies are going up. I don't know.
I was shocked. I still love my toes, but still. I mean, and she did a wonderful, she did a great job. I think what happens, I'm not sure. I think what happens is that kind of like when a teacher gets their degree, if they start off with a bachelor's or a master's, they get paid different money, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I think the same thing happens with, like, you know, manicurists and stuff. I think if they have certain qualifications and certain years, like certain levels, you know, the senior, the master, the whatever, then I think they probably are in a higher pay. I don't know. Yeah, $55.
Wow.
I know.
Well, the same girl has always, I always did my nails, because they only have two ladies up there that do the nails. And then they got a lady that does the nails and eyebrows, and a lady that does the nails, eyebrows, and the pedicures. So, yeah. If the one girl, when she would do my nails, the other girl did my pedicure. So, because she had a lot of clients that come in, she was really a nice person, and she is very nice, because she would make arrangements for people when people got, they closed at like 7, but she'd stay there and do them after work and maybe not get home till 10 at night, or come in early in the morning before they opened and do them. She was really accommodating to people, all the time.
Yeah, my hair guy does eyebrows and hair, you know, everything with hair, but he doesn't do any nails at all.
Oh.
And I had never met this gal. I don't know. She looked like she was 12, so I can't imagine she's been there a bunch of years. But she did do a good job, except when she very first started, I said, ouch. And she looked and she goes, it isn't bleeding. I thought, oh, this is going to be fun. And
which
then
probably cutting your the cuticles back around your toes, the skin back. Yeah. And it doesn't make your toes sore. And they can, you know, accidentally nip you a little bit, but they put stuff on it and it goes away. So
right. Well, she had a little bit of an aggressive personality, which at first I was kinda like, okay, she's gonna get 3 strikes and I'm out of here, you know? And and it turned out she was a joy to, you know, because I mean I was in there for 65 minutes, like I said. So she had a very interesting personality. She confided in me that she gets high. I thought that was interesting. I'm like, wow, you don't even know who I am, you know?
Really? Oh, wow.
But she was telling me all about her health challenges. She didn't use that term, but you know, it was very interesting and she was very enjoyable. And
she must have felt comfortable talking to you, or she wouldn't have gone there. I don't think.
Well, Star Mama, people tell me everything. Sometimes it's like, ooh, don't tell me that, because then you might not want to talk to me after you tell me all that, you know?
I've had people do that to me, you know, and I ran several clubs years and years ago, and I bartended, and let me tell you, if people don't think bartenders don't hear every story there is, and they don't think somebody that's drunk don't tell the truth. They tell the truth when they're drunk, let me tell you. They go a mile a minute. But see, I had a policy even back then, and I haven't bartended since 1993. So it's been that many years ago. But even back then, I had certain ones. They knew when they come, they had to give me their car keys, because they knew they wasn't going to leave unless I thought they were okay. They drank coffee. They were cut off the last hour. We served sandwiches and stuff. If I felt like they still weren't able, I called either cab or I called their wife or girlfriend to come get them. They knew, or else I didn't serve them. And that was my right. And
for you.
You know, well, I just felt responsible.
I was dispatching at that time when you were bartending. Mm-hmm. And back then, it was not uncommon when there was a drunk driver for me to get a phone number over the radio to call to say, come and pick up your husband.
Right.
You know, it's different now. Now, if you register, plus the limits were higher too.
Well, now they can hold a bartender responsible.
Yes.
If they serve. But I wouldn't even, when people come in late and I didn't know them, I wouldn't even serve them. I told them, I'm sorry. You know, it's an hour and closing. I don't know you. I don't know where all you've been or how much you've had to drink. And I don't do that. Yeah. You know, and luckily the two guys that owned the place left those decisions up to me.
Yes. Know?
So that's the way it was. And I didn't drink. I don't drink anyway. And people say, how do you do that all that time? And because they comped us three drinks a night plus our pay. And I just give my drinks, you know, to whoever, you know, if they help stock the cooler or something, you know, right, doing things like that, or, you know, took some stuff back to the back for me.
I didn't drink.
Yeah.
I thought it was so funny the other day, people getting started early on their vacation. And I got three different phone calls from friends who all three of them I could tell had been already, one of them drinks bourbon. I know one of them drinks wine. I could tell by the conversation. I'm thinking, I'm a non-drinker. How do I have all these drunks for friends?
Last time I had, it was 2 years ago, actually 2 years ago this month, that I had a drink. And I had, I think it was a strawberry daiquiri. That's what I had.
Oh yeah, I could see you. I could see you doing that. Mm-hmm. That would be your drink.
And I drank about half of it. I couldn't drink any more of it because I felt like I couldn't even, my head was just spinning, you know. Because they made them strong, and I just said no.
Yeah. That we're non-drinkers. We're just easy drunks, I think.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I never cared for beer. Never cared for beer, or whiskeys or martinis. No, none of that stuff. I thought that was always so gross, but yeah.
Well, I like to have a little glass of wine. And
oh, I do too, occasionally. Yeah.
Yeah. My go-to is like on the holiday or whatever. Mm-hmm. I'm going to black this one. There, I got rid of Sherry, you guys.
Got rid of who?
Sherry. I guess she was posting crap.
Oh really? Yeah. I'm gonna go off the camera for a little bit because I'm gonna get me something to drink and I'm gonna look at the chat.
Okay. So yeah, yeah, I used to, but if I pour a glass of wine, I can get about halfway through the glass and then it never fails. I'm always like, are my lips puffy? That's always the first hint that I have that maybe, okay, you know, I can feel it. So yeah, people, I'm always the designated driver, always.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's good. I used to take people and drop them off too if they were on my way home. I didn't mind doing it, you know, but yeah, the time their wives or girlfriends was always glad. They said, you know, and I didn't want to be responsible for them getting out, hurting somebody or hurting themselves or passing out in the car and getting, you know, for being, you know, public intoxication. You know, I didn't want that.
Well, times were different then too. I can't remember what the limits even were back then, but now, you know, they've lowered the limits so low. I could probably have one glass of wine and be at the limit, you know, I don't know.
Yeah. I know a lot of times I had this one guy, he always wanted to come in and get the 151 room. He knew I wouldn't serve him because he was the only one.
What that was, ever that come in. Was that like Don Quixote or something?
Oh, I don't know. It was called 151 room. And that's the only person to ever come in. And this guy's name was Jerry. He just couldn't handle it. I mean, and I knew he would try to pay people to come up and get, I said, Jerry, it isn't working. You're not getting that room. And he'd go, damn. Yeah. Yeah. They're funny. Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to think. I think maybe I'm wrong with the name. It's something like Don Quixote or something. That was big back in the late 70s, early 80s.
I don't know what that is. We served a lot of Long Island iced tea and margaritas and pina coladas and strawberry drinks, yeah.
The rum and coke with that 151 and you are blasted.
Yeah. Oh yeah. I can just Oh, this one girl by Charlotte, she said she found out yesterday she has the C.
Oh, no, Charlotte, no.
Sorry, I know a lot of people that I have a friend whose mother just found out she had it. They've been treating her for bronchitis, and she tested positive for it also. Yeah.
How's she doing? How's she doing now?
She, you know, they've got her on all different kinds of, like, inhalers, and they give her a steroid injection. They put her on another antibiotic, and she's having x-rays done Tuesday of her lungs to make sure it's not gone into pneumonia, because she's 76 years old. So, you know, she worries about her mom a lot. But they told her that it was just an upper respiratory infection. But she had a real bad cough, and I thought it was odd that, you know, I go in sometimes for that, but I never had a bad cough, and she had a bad cough, and she was running a fever, which I didn't do. So, no, they didn't test me. I think the doctor probably should have tested her then, having that fever and a cough, because those are usually signs, you know, of that. But she got really bad. Yeah.
Is she doing better now?
Yeah, well, you know, they just changed her medicines Friday, and she was going to, well, of course, Monday's holiday, so she couldn't get the test done. So Tuesday, she's actually supposed to get her x-rays done on her lungs. And that's the way with my daughter. I told you that she fell decorating her son's her Christmas party for the Honor Society last year. Yeah. And she fell on her hand, and she crushed it. All right. Well, the doctor, when he did a wonderful job, he put a plate in her hand, and everything, and she was at about 80% a couple of months ago, and she went and had a CT scan done the other day, and what he told her was he's got to go get a piece of bone that he couldn't get to, that it was lodged someplace, and he would have had to really get her in there for several hours, and sometimes those bones will work their way out and dissolve, but this one didn't. But he's already going to go in and remove the metal that he put in her hand, because her bone healed.
Good.
And he said that that way she won't have that sensitivity to the cold and stuff, you know. But he did tell her he was going to have to cut her pretty far up her arm to go in there and get that bone. It's way up in her arm. So, yeah, she's kind of, you know, didn't want to have to do that, because she told her it would just be, you know, that outer skin, you know, healing, just going in there, removing the plate and then sewing it up. But he said, no, he's going to have to go there. So she's going to be a little irritated for, you know, 2-3 weeks. But
it sounds like he's a really good doctor.
Oh, he is. And he, you know, he's taking pictures. You know, he's actually, I went with her when we went back in for the first time after she got out of the hospital. And he walked in and shook hands with me. He said, I'm going to be honest with you. He said, she had me sweating in there in the surgery room. He said, I didn't know if I was going to be able to fix her hand. He said, it was a mess. He said, I really didn't know if I was going to be able to do much for her. And he said, I'm proud, he said, of the job I've done. And he's took pictures and everything. Yes.
You even have surgeons who are telling you their deepest, darkest.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. That's, you know what I mean? That they can sense that in you, that they're able to trust you.
Yeah. He just said, you know, I was in there 3 hours, and he said, I'm telling you, he said, I was sweating it. He said, I didn't know if I was going to be able to really restore her hand. But, you know, in that one scar, people look at her like, oh, we know what you tried to do, because the way it's cut, you know, she looks like she tried to, where the scar is, you know, like they look when they try to cut their wrist and stuff, but it's fading. He said, don't let people like that bother you. He said, you've got a medical documentation if they ever want to challenge you on that. It's all documented. He said, people do that just to be cruel. And he said, they do a lot of things not knowing your situation. So,
right.
You know, but I'm glad, because I was really concerned. I seen it in the bone. When I took her to the emergency room, the teacher brought her here so I could take her to the hospital, and the bone was sticking out of her skin. And nice. I was freaking out, driving 25 minutes to get her over there to the hospital. And I didn't know, I had to leave to go pick the boys up from school. And this older lady was sitting out there. She finally went and got a nurse. She said, this girl's bleeding all over. You've got to get out here and do something. They took in the cloth back and looked, and they went, oh, my God. And they took her straight back. And they had them in there working on her stat, because it was bad. You know, bone was completely through. And then you get infections, you know, in your bone and stuff if that stays open. So, yeah, it was something. But she does good, you know.
Do you hear my dog eating this fake cough?
Yeah.
He came right up here to do it again. I think he knows that we're doing a live chat, and he thinks it's a cool idea.
Well, that's the way Mia's dog does. He always does that when she goes live. She said he knows, and he'll start that coughing, and he'll carry on and just bark and bark because he thinks he can keep getting treats from her that she'll just keep giving them to her.
Oh, that's so sweet to keep him quiet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he thinks that because she'll give him to him. So he'll be quiet for a little bit, and he'll start barking. And she shut him out of her room, and he's standing there by the door barking anyway. He was figured he was going to get some more treats, and I'm sure he probably did. He's an older dog, but yeah, his name's Teddy, and yeah.
Yeah, well, he's been doing it lately where it seems like when we're talking, and all of a sudden he comes up within a couple feet of me, and he's going, that I'm like,
what? I'm sure. Yeah, that's funny.
Okay,
yeah.
I see Bell Puffer now. Do you want to put a picture up, or do you want to go like this? Thumb, do your thumb in the air up if you want me to click you on. Or you can put a picture up if you want. Either way. I see your beautiful smile, but I don't see your thumb.
That's another reason why I decided to go live. I'm going to shut these people up, and I am not Menz's daughter. So shut the hell up about that. Get over it. Now you know what I look like. Really. People are so... I don't understand him.
Well, now he came to the other side of me, right beside me, and he had to do like the shake, like as if he was out in the rain or something, which he wasn't. What on earth?
Mm.
What a little stinker. So Nurse Nene Cringe, mm-hmm. I'm looking at the chat. It looks like they're talking about what would Christopher Watts' wife do if she had been alive during the C word.
Oh my gosh. She would, I thought that'd been horrible for everybody because she had been trapped in that house and they would have shut all those, all the things, the trips down and everything. She wouldn't have been going anyplace. Can you imagine? Oh my gosh. I can only imagine.
Probably would have had like 5 masks on Bella.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she would have been like, don't come near me. Don't come near me.
Well, you know, there's another thing that me and I was talking about a little bit on that. You know how everybody has questioned SW's shirt she had on. It looked like she had a lot of blood on that shirt and stuff, you know, on the rubber shirt. Well, we got to thinking about that. Well, what if she was holding, what if that was from Bella's mouth?
I don't know anything about blood on a shirt.
Yeah, it was on her shirt that she was found in. Everybody thought that stuff on the shirt was blood stains and stuff. And it's up around, you know, where, and we got to think, well, if that's blood, because see, they've got everything so sealed about this thing. But what if she was actually, if that was actually from Bella? I'm wondering about that now because of the way her mouth was. Because it just, they don't even mention that, any kind of stains and stuff on the pajamas like that, you would have thought they would have listed something or there had been blood trails someplace. And that's why I still think their clothes, I still think they were killed in those clothes they had on Sunday at that birthday party. And they were put in those pajamas later. That's what I think. Because it just, I don't know. She would have bled a lot from that. With her mouth like that.
There was something in Christopher Watts' wife's stomach too, that I know at one time we were wondering if it was that syrup of ipecac or charcoal or whatever.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So could it be that she had some kind of upchuck on her shirt?
I don't know.
Well, hearing that last night with Mia about the girls being smothered.
Yes.
Because, you know, over the last few years, there have been more and more people trying to say they were strangled.
Mm-hmm. They weren't.
Christopher Watts said in his interview, didn't he, that they were strangled?
Mm-hmm.
And they were smothered.
They were smothered, yes. But I was not aware of the additional injuries to her face. I did not know about that. I didn't either.
Yeah, I didn't.
And when she showed me that, I went on that one live, and I went, oh my gosh, she said, I had no idea. And she said, well, I hated to even show you it because she said, you act like you were pretty stressed about it. And I said, yeah, but I said, you need to know those things. If you miss those things, you need to be aware of that in case you wonder why, how did that come about, you know, and why is that not, you know, it's only mentioned. And then that's the end of it. There's no explanation that was given for it. You know, it's just, I don't know.
And then 4 years later, I'm hearing it for the first time.
Yes, I know. Well, I didn't know about it. I just heard about it. You know, that's why I had her tell you, because my mind was blown and I went, oh my gosh, I had no idea. You know, I just didn't.
So maybe that's what the scumbag attackers are for, is to just keep us too busy to read anything.
Yes. So did Bell Pepper just figure out how to come up or what?
She was up there, but I asked her to do a thumbs up and she didn't. She was smiling very, very.
Oh, she said in here, she said, enjoyed the show. I have to go. I guess she couldn't get in or something. Didn't know how to do it or put a picture up or whatever. I don't know. She just said, thank you, lady.
Yeah, I saw her face, but I didn't want to click on it without seeing her thumbs up.
Right.
Because we know how the scumbag attackers are.
Yeah. Well, they tell you to make sure you know the people back there, because there's been guys that come in there and try to show nude pictures or nude, you know, profiles of themselves and flash everybody.
I don't mean Bell Pepper, but if she didn't mean to go on camera, then I wouldn't want to put her up there.
Oh, yeah, I know. Yeah.
Because then, you know, they would be taking screenshots and trying to figure out which way her window was facing, north or south or whatever, you know. Mm-hmm. They have to examine.
And I do agree with Bonita. She did constantly have a lot of blankets and pillows and objects in their beds. They were covered with.
Photo op. Remember that? How many different pictures of those four babies having their faces covered?
Mm-hmm.
And then they ended up smothered.
Yeah. And then to find out and to see where she was in the SIDS Facebook groups for the sudden infant death groups. That really blew my mind. Yeah. I thought, yeah.
Exactly.
You know, she knew better, because if she's in there at all and knew anything, she knows that back then that was well known. You don't put covers in there. You don't put blankets. You don't put even toys in there.
Like, you know, you could learn that. And most teenage babysitters don't even take a class, but a teenager knows better. So, you know, I heard in another video, they keep referring to her. And I'm talking not people who are actually discussing the case, but the people who are discussing other channels.
Mm-hmm.
They keep referring to her as this young mom. Mm.
Yeah, well, she wasn't a young mom. Mm-hmm.
Not at all. And, you know, did she have any common sense about any of that? That one picture of Cece coming down the stairs head first?
Yeah. And that's something else that we were talking about. And I was talking about, she's with us now. She thinks that she was older than what is being told, that SW was older, closer maybe to 40. Yeah.
Yeah, I think she was 40 to 42 years old.
Mm-hmm.
Who said that? Mia?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, good for Mia.
She agrees because she was looking at her the way, well, in that video where she's doing that makeup tutorial, she was looking at her face, the wrinkles. She was looking at that hair, the styles, the way more her nails, her clothes, the way she dressed.
Yep.
Just her general appearance and then she looked at the wedding dress and everything she chose. She said it just didn't look like somebody that was at the age at that time, like in their early 30s. It didn't make sense to her, you know, like it should have been.
Mm-hmm. And Honey Badger said that too, about the dress that she was wearing in high school, that was not the right year.
Yes.
That's what Honey Badger said too, that she thinks she was, I think, 42.
Mm-hmm. And I think now she's kind of on board. She thinks there's a possibility there were more babies too. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I think so.
I actually think the one, I'm not going to say the name of the place that she supposedly had worked at stuff and what all went on. I'm kind of thinking that possibly there was one or two set of twins maybe that was his and they were adopted is what I'm thinking. I'm beginning to really think that. There's some, and you know, somebody come in and put in, I did not know this, but they said that there is pictures of both senior and junior that are working for that place that where she was supposedly worked at and got in trouble for those charges that they dropped. Yes, people are saying they are working for him right now, both of them.
They said that during an Alice Cooper live.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I thought, wow, that's just crazy. I don't know.
Think about this too, though. Her shoes were not exactly something a 33 to 34 year old would have been wearing. Mm-hmm. Her purses were nothing that a 33 or 34 year old would have been collecting like that. Right. Her hairstyle, her eyebrows, her manicure, her wrinkles, the mm-hmm. whole bit, even her idea of her makeup routine and stuff. I think she was patterning after somebody much older who was telling her how she had to do it. I don't think she had the, you know, when you're a young gal and you're in high school, junior high, and you're hanging out with your girlfriends and you're figuring out makeup and everything, there's a lot of female mm-hmm. planning that goes on with cutting each other's hair and waxing each other's eyebrows and stuff.
Right.
Right? I don't think she had those experiences. I think she learned from her mother. I don't think she had friendships in high school.
Well, I think there was a big age difference between her mom and her dad, too. Just my opinion. But I
do, too. Yeah, I do, too.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I think that her style of dress and everything, I think she was much older than we're being told. And I think she basically had her training by patterning after her mother. Mm-hmm. Because I think she missed out on her teenage years. I do. I think those, what were they called? Migraines? I think possibly required a lot of inpatient care.
Right. Yeah, Bonita. Yeah, that is true, Bonita. I have looked and I cannot find where she graduated from high school at all. There's nothing. I can't find anything under her maiden name, under any. I just can't find it. It's just not there. I've looked. There's nothing there. Using the high school that the name and stuff that she said that she went to. So that's why I think it's all baloney about the nursing and all the different things anyway, because she would have to have a high school diploma. I don't even think you can have a GED now and get into nursing programs. I think you have to have a diploma. So you would almost have to have a diploma. She couldn't even, she wouldn't even been eligible to apply, would she, without a diploma? I don't know. That's just crazy.
Well, nursing school is different than how she was trying to make it appear.
Right.
She claimed that she applied and she was magically accepted. That isn't how it works.
Yeah.
You know, she hadn't taken A&P at all. Nor would she have been able to have passed that class.
Right.
So, yeah.
So she'd have been a disgrace to nurses. So it's just a blessing that. Yeah.
She never would have made it through. And I think her performance in whatever couple of classes she signed up for pretty much shows that.
Mm-hmm. I get to thinking, I know this is horrible. I get to thinking about that one nurse that had that was killing all those kids and stuff in the hospital when she was a nurse there. And I thought, oh my gosh, you know, there's actually women that have done that's had the profile that she did about the Munchausen by proxy. That lady had the same issues. And I thought, wow. And she was a nurse and they couldn't explain all the deaths and stuff until they started watching her and they caught her finally, you know?
Well, Taya, I hope that if anybody is suffering from any of the same behavior patterns that we've been discussing from what we've noticed with this case.
Mm-hmm.
I hope that they, or if they have a close friend or a sister or someone who is suffering like that, I really hope they do everything they can to try to help, to try to make sure that they're helped, because, well, you know what I think. Bella and Cece deserve to be safe.
Right. And it's just like Mia said, she said, I'm not keeping my mouth shut anymore. She said, I don't care who it makes mad, what they think, you know, they don't have to come here. I'll block them. I don't care anymore. I'm going by facts and I'm showing people proof. And if they can't look at those videos and see what she was doing to those little girls, then they don't even need to bother coming and even talking to me, because they cannot just not see that she had problems, that she was disconnected from the kids and she was doing things that were not right. And she said, you know, and it is in every video. I would wish somebody would show me one video that she was not abusive toward those girls in some way. And even him, she was verbally abusive to him all the time. It's just, I don't know. It just, to me, it's just, I don't know how people cannot see that unless, I don't know how they can say, well, they didn't approve of her techniques and the way she was raising her little girls. They wouldn't have done it that way, but they're not going to speak out and say anything about what she did. Well, I am. I'm going to speak out because it was wrong what she did. It just was. The thing she did was wrong. And you should never, ever upset a child to the point to where they're shaking and they are terrified because of Santa Claus or the Easter Bunny or anything like that. Who does that?
She was pushing Bella to tears.
Yeah.
Bella wasn't crying until her mother was tormenting her.
Mm-hmm.
And when people post comments how she was such a wonderful mother, I just think, what planet are you on?
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah.
Even then, like if they want to sit over on their channel and say how she was such a wonderful mother, they being whoever, you know, watches those videos and thinks they saw a wonderful mother in action.
Right.
Hallelujah. That's their opinion. But mm-hmm. don't go joining forces to try to tell me that I'm bashing her.
Yeah. You know? Well, that's their favorite place to go. And it's like that one lady there. She said she'd been in there and always been nice. And then she come there and was accusing us of doing that. And we weren't even, we were taught, we're playing a video of that one lady's interview and talking about the fact that she thought that the CM guy was CW and that's who she was married to. She didn't even know what SW's husband looked like. She was even confused. And we were had nothing to do with her mother's skill or nothing. And this lady come out of nowhere and just was trying to rip her apart. She said, you can just get out of here. She said, I don't care. You know, I just don't care. I'm not doing anything wrong and you can just stop, you know, but that's what they do. They want to try to, they want to mess with anybody that wants to bring anything to light and with facts. That's exactly what it is.
Yeah. Exactly. Bell Pepper's back.
Okay.
Bell Pepper, I just saw your comments in the private chat. I didn't see those. I'm sorry. If you want to hop up again, I'll go ahead and post.
Oh, okay.
Or paste. Copy and paste. Here we go.
Okay.
Wait, that might be Paula's channel. Hold on. Hold on a minute.
Oh, gosh.
Okay, here, we'll try this again.
I'm just glad I figured out how to do it. That was a challenge, you know?
Oh, my gosh. I'm so glad. I feel excited for you.
Yeah, I'm a little, you know, antsy, but I'll get it. You know, it's just a learning. If I had, you know, had a way of somebody following me around when I'm trying to move, it would be much better. You know, so that's the point of the tripod, you know, and stuff. I can adjust it, you know, and work with it that way. Yeah,
I think you're a natural at it, though. You just have the gift of gab, which is a total compliment. You're articulate, you're kind, you're funny. Here we are.
Yep.
Sorry about that earlier. I was waiting for your thumb.
Oh.
Oh, there's your thumb. Okay.
Sorry about that. Technology sucks for me. I'm still working on it.
You came to the right place.
But Star Mama, I just want to know, do you have that book of recipes or is it all in your mind?
No, I don't have a book of recipes. It's most of it, except for the chocolate cake I did. And I've made that cake for probably 30 years or at least. And I finally just started, as I was doing it, I actually figured out the measurements on that, but it took 30 years of doing that to figure that one out. I watched my grandmother and she would literally cup stuff in her hand and say about this much. So a pinch here and, you know, about like I was doing in those, that's just the way I cook. I just do. And, you know, my daughter even told my grandson the other day, I can't make Nana's potato salad because she doesn't have a recipe. And he said, well, I've got to watch her when you make those cheese enchiladas, Nana. I've got to learn how to do that because you don't have a recipe. And that's what he was telling me. So he actually, the last two or three times I made them, which I'm going to do them for everybody. That's another cheap meal you can actually make.
It's just like mashed potatoes.
Mm-hmm.
I'd love to know how you do your mashed potatoes.
Well, I can do one on that. Yeah.
There's a secret to perfect mashed potatoes, but like you say, a pinch here, a pinch there. Mm-hmm. It's not easy to do.
Well, you got to make sure your potato. I only use those gold or the red potatoes for mashed potatoes. And I just, you know, make sure that they're cooked to where, you know, they're not going to be lumpy. And I use an old-fashioned potato masher. And I use just a, I use about, you're not going to believe, I use a whole stick of butter in there with salt and pepper. And I stream in a little bit of half and half at a time until it's the consistency I want them.
Half and half. Mom never told me half and half.
Yeah, I use half and half. Yeah.
Well, back in those days, you used evaporated milk.
Yes, you can use that too, but I use, you know, evaporated milk's pretty expensive right now, actually, for a can of it. It's gone up really high. People were forced to use it for baby formula when the baby formula was short, so, yeah.
Right, and that's what we're trying to do is to present ways that people can kind of stretch their food dollars.
And I'm going to make macaroni and cheese, too. You can make a big thing of macaroni and cheese cheap. I'm just telling you, you can.
Well, when I first heard you doing the roast, you just, like I said again, you sounded like the home ec teacher, and it was perfect. I mean that as a compliment.
Oh, well, thank you.
Star Mama, I think your channel's going to take right off. I really do.
I wish it would.
Take off, and yeah, I think you're going to be.
I hope so. I hope so, because I plan to stick with it. You know, as long as I got people that are interested, I'll do it. Even maybe if it's just 100 people, you know, I'll do it.
Maybe I could be your book agent or something and get you a publishing deal.
Oh, gosh. Now y'all are really getting ahead here.
I enjoy it. Yeah. I enjoy it very well.
And, you know, I'm going to ask for people for things that people would like to have recipes on, because I've got recipes for Swiss steak, beef stew, vegetable soup. I could chicken and dumplings. I mean, but I can't tell you how much, because you just have to watch me. But at least y'all can go back and play the videos and do like I do. And I go back and taste things. You know, I'm not always get it. You know, I'm not rocket science at this. I have to go by taste too. And I might underestimate my salt, pepper, or something. But I do use a little pinch of, and you'll see that, about a teaspoon of sugar in my potato salad, because my grandmother did that. And she does it in her macaroni and cheese. She did it in her spaghetti sauce, everything. That little bit of sugar, because she said it took the wang out of things, you know.
Yeah, when you said that, that just floored me. Nobody ever told me that the acidity, that the mm-hmm. sugar took it out of the spaghetti sauce. Nobody ever told us that in school.
Yeah. And actually, she says it takes the bitterness, too, off of certain cheeses when you're making macaroni and cheese. You'll get that little bitter taste. And she would put a pinch of nutmeg in there, too. She said, you won't know what's in there. But with your white sauces and your mac and cheese, it's a good idea to put a little tiny pinch of that in there.
Yeah. You're kidding me.
No.
I never heard of that. Oh, my gosh. You are a star.
Well, thank you.
I mean, you're old school, but I love it. And I mean that nicely.
Thank you. Well, I am 71, and I, you know, I did take home economics and stuff in school, but I wanted to learn to cook, and I had a grandmother that said, if you want to learn to cook, you're going to have to come in here and watch me, because I don't measure things. You're going to have to watch what I do. And I learned to, my mom said I come the closest to her pies as anyone, because ever did. It's with her. She said, nobody can get them as close as you do. So, yeah.
I would never think you were 71. I had a lot of fun.
Oh, well, thank you. Oh, I am. Believe me. Yeah. Well, thanks. I appreciate
that.
Are
you going to call us Star Mama? Are you going to keep the name Star Mama?
On the channel, I think so. It seems to be, yeah. Yeah. And I went to that because there was a lot of, my other name was Paula, but there was a lot of Paulas, and people were getting, I was getting accused of doing things and opinions and stuff, and it wasn't me, because they wouldn't say Paula E or Paula J like mine was. They wasn't putting the last name, so it was causing quite a bit of thing when people had like five or six Paulas in one chat. So I said, I got to change that. You know, it just was too confusing. So
exactly. We get blamed for enough. We don't need to be blamed for everyone else with the same name too.
But that's what my friends called me, with Star Mama. So that's where they come from.
They're
younger. They're girls that are 40, 50 years old. And they said, oh, you're our star mom. You know, that's what they say to me. So yeah, that's how I got that name. Yeah.
Oh, I thought maybe it was your CB handle or something.
Oh, no. It was just that I just friends named me Star Mama. Yeah,
and if anybody in the chat knows what a CB handle means, then you're old.
Yeah, well, I do.
Yeah, but I know what I mean.
You got a smoky at your back door. Yeah.
Are we doing Smokey and the Bandit?
Yeah. Yeah, that's true.
I can tell you what my CB handle was, because I think it would be considered like not culturally acceptable or whatever.
Yeah. Yeah.
We'd probably get the channel struck down and all the scumbag attackers would be laughing. Mm-hmm.
But you know, there's a lot of guys that like to cook too. I have found that out, but they need somebody, you know, they're interested, but they want to learn to cook other and just stuff that, you know, out of boxes. They do want to learn that. So, yeah.
Take a look at this. You see it? This is Ben.
She's funny. Oh my gosh. Yeah. She was cutting up last night too. She had me. That's one thing about the chat. It kind of gets can just get distracting, and you just start laughing at what people are saying. You won't even realize, you know, that may not be appropriate for what's going on that you're talking about in the live, you know, because they get off on some things in here. Yeah. Oh, that's a good idea. Star Mama's Home Cooking. That's kind of cool. Yeah, I like that too.
Oh, I like that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I do.
I'm excited. If anyone is new to the chat, Star Mama started her own. Well, she already had, right? I mean, everyone has a channel, but
right.
She's building her channel, and she's uploaded two videos already to her channel. And I will go ahead and link it again here. Let's see.
And Mrs. Ben said, "Star Mama and the Kitchen Bobs." That's a good one.
It sounds like a band.
Yeah.
Like a musical.
Oh my gosh, yes. And then my son-in-law was telling me, he said, "Well, I can probably teach you how to edit in the background. You could play a little bit of music or something if you wanted to." And I thought, oh boy, it's really trying to get me advanced quick, man.
Canon by Pocket Bell. It'd be like so cool.
Yeah. Well, okay, thanks, guys. I appreciate the compliments and stuff. That's really sweet of you. I appreciate it.
Let's see how many you have right now. Mm-hmm. 61. You're up to 61.
Yeah. Good. Thanks, guys. Keep going. And I plan, you know, there I've got a lot of recipes that different desserts. I've got some desserts for summertime. I got desserts for spring, fall, around holidays. I mean, I just got a lot of different inside salads and jello salads and all different kinds of things that you can make that they're not complicated and they taste pretty good.
Hot Ham is noticing your refrigerator. That, uh-oh, ladies and gentlemen, is what a refrigerator is supposed to look like.
Yeah, the art and all my the pictures. Well, we used to have them all over the front stuff. They kept coming off every time somebody would open or shut their refrigerator door. So I moved a lot of them to the side, but we still get a lot of, I have a lot of art that still goes on that front from grandkids. Believe me, it goes up there. It just does.
You know, just to say that point, everybody that has grandchildren, they put their art on the refrigerator. And when you've seen SW's house, you didn't see anything out of place, if you know what I mean. If you have grandchildren, you knew things get out of place. But they have no pictures that's made. In daycares, the pictures when they're in daycare, and that's what they were in daycare. She never posted that, and I always thought that was a little strange.
Yeah, well, I don't think that house, that's fine. The house, I for the most part, I don't think even looked lived in. You know, you wouldn't know there were children there, that's for sure. You just wouldn't have. And that stuff bothered me. It bothered me.
They had no art of the kids, the kids' art, right. None of it.
Mm-hmm. I know.
You never saw any pictures made from the kids or toys downstairs. Come on.
That was one of the first talking points when the case first hit the headlines in the first couple of months. That's what people were noticing, that there was no refrigerator art. Where were the toys? Why was it that the girls weren't running around the house acting like kids?
Yes.
We didn't know at the time that they were getting dosed up at 6:30 every night with Benadryl and Tylenol.
All right.
I think she said Munchausen.
Oh, yeah. Brooke said, how do I find Star Mama's channel? I think Minza put the link in earlier for it.
Well, I just put it in again.
You just put it in again. It's there.
Three times in the last 5 minutes. So
she's going to push it, man.
Susan says, because all of her shit was packed up.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
Moving day.
I think it was moving day. Oh, I, and you've got, it's just like with Mia, she's there. She said that makes more sense every day that goes by. It just points more in that direction, you know.
And every strange little detail that comes along fits into the moving day theory.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
But when she did the videos, the cooking videos, you never saw anything out of place. You know what I mean? When you do.
I never saw any cooking. House.
Are you talking about when she did cannolis, the eggs and stuff? Oh, yes. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I think she bought those little shells, you know. Yeah, she bought the little shells, and I think she just, it's really not that hard to make them. You've got your mascarpone cheese, you've got ricotta cheese, you've got powdered sugar. And you've got mini chocolate chips you use. It's not hard at all. You mix it, you beat that stuff up, and you let it set up, and you bake those little cups off. Mm-hmm. You buy them pre-baked. You fill them, and you throw the chocolate chips on them. They're not hard at all.
Do you really believe that she did all of that? I don't believe she did all of that. I think she bought cans of something and scooped it into the little cups.
Mesmer Mom said that she made the chicken breast crock pot with pecani recipe. Thanks. Yeah, it's good. Because that's simple. It's like I said, I take 4 chicken breasts, throw them in a crock pot, I put a half a bunch of cilantro in there. I take and put a whole medium-sized jar of the pecani sauce. You let it cook till you can pull the chicken apart. And you leave that, you don't add any water or anything. You take and add a can of drained black beans and a can of drained whole corn. You put that in there, and I squeeze a lime in there. And you let that get hot and stuff, and you serve that with tostadas or chips. I mean, it is really good, and it is filling, and it's a meal. You've got your meat, you've got your fish, and those black beans are good for you, and they're in there. And the kids, they don't say anything about it because they like the taste of pecani sauce and the corn, and they don't really mind the black beans in there at all. It's easy, and it's quick. And you can be doing other things while that's cooking. And you've got dinner ready. It's just that simple. There's nothing hard about it.
Hot Ham Radio's wondering about the term kiddo. And I think it's interesting because, you know, granted I'm older. I know that there was a time frame there where a lot of people referred to their kids as kiddos, right?
Well, yeah. she called him. She said, hey kid, that's mine. And stuff. She also said, called him mama, said, hey mama, you know, to him and stuff. So yeah, I don't know. She said a lot of things. She also called him other things too. Monsters, bad heads, everything else you can think of. So yeah.
I think she picked up that mama thing from one of her friends who was Latina.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah. I think that kiddo thing actually kind of came and went.
Mesmer Mom, it's my channel, the link, Minza just posted the link up here in the chat. Look back in the chat and you'll see it where she posted the link to it. I just did it a few hours, there she posted again, right under. And I just set that up earlier today. It was quick, believe me. I already had my channel, of course, and I just loaded those. But I couldn't go live because I looked into it, and YouTube's, you have to have at least 50 subs, and it takes 24 hours for them to approve you to let you go live. And then once you do that, then I was looking at pictures and stuff, and they said, your community posts, you can't use your community page until you have 1,000. So that's where a lot of people post recipes. They post the pictures, but I found out you can post the recipes up under the videos. But it's hard to do that when you're
well, right now,
home cook because you don't have an exact recipe for that, you know?
right now we're on the Lady Justice channel, and that has like 4,200 and some subscribers.
Mm-hmm. Right. And
if you you said Mia was going to help.
Yeah, I sent her the link earlier, and I asked her if she would put that up. So because people had asked me about it, I'd been thinking about this, you know, for a while, but I thought, you know, I'm just gonna have a bunch of people come in and start crap, you know, and stuff, and I just didn't want to deal with it. But you know, if they do, I'll just have to deal with it. You know, if they do that over a cooking channel, they're pretty, you know, they're pretty low, you know.
Well, we're not gonna let you just be a cooking channel though. We're gonna get over there and talk to crime too.
Before you know it. True crime and cooking. home cooking with a touch of true crime. Yep, that'd be good.
Before you know it, you're gonna be emailing me saying, "Why are you going live? I'm going live."
Yeah. We'll have to at least email each other back and forth, because I know you don't like to always post it. So because of what they do with it. Yeah.
Prepared.
Yeah.
I kind of like, though, when we advertise this as a cooking video, then the scumbag attackers stay away.
Right. I'm going to mute for just a minute because I've got to take my dogs out. They're wanting to go to the bath.
Yeah. True crime and pot roast. There you go. This is Ben. You have a good sense of humor. I think it's exciting. I think that the channel's going to take right off. And I think that before we know it, Star Mama's going to have over 1,000 subs. And then she'll be able to post recipes every day. Okay, Brooke says, Child Protective Services started calling foster care children kiddo. Ooh. Got it. Is it still going on? Or is it something that kind of came and went?
I didn't know that. That's interesting. Yes. Wow. I didn't know that.
And I think it is kind of an, it was just like, I don't know, 7-8 years maybe. Mm-hmm. I think it came and went.
Wow. I had no idea about that term. That's the first time I'd heard that.
Mary just subbed.
Oh, good. That's nice. I need all the help I can. And I'm even going to show you how to make a quiche too, using, you don't have to learn to do a pie crust. You can just buy the frozen pie crust. They're actually about the same price if you make it or you buy them. But I can show you how to whip up a quiche with just a few veggies and eggs and a little bit of milk or cream. And you can throw in, you know, about any kind of meat you want, from Spam to fried up bacon to sausage to ham, whatever you want, you know, in there. Do a lot of interesting things.
We haven't started cooking at all, but what we have done, actually the cooking has just begun, because Star Mama uploaded a couple of cooking videos to her new channel.
Mm-hmm.
She's launching her cooking channel. And there's the link. So hop on over there and subscribe.
Yeah, I cannot go live yet until I had to have at least 50 subs. And then I have to wait for YouTube to approve me, which takes 24 hours. So I couldn't go live today. I already tried that, and that was a no-no. So, yeah. But those are I did record those the best I could, those recipes. So you've got something, a couple of them there. And I did give you all the ingredients for the cake, which is accurate. Those were accurate measurements. If you do it, like I said, I mean, you're going to turn out and have a pretty good chocolate cake. And then also the steps on the roast. I did send Miss Menz a picture of the cake and the roast. I can't post those pictures until I get a community page. So I'm kind of I'm going to have to almost do them at the end of the videos. So you can see the end results, but you can see the meatloaf and you can also see the potato salad that I made. But you have to just kind of watch. It's all done, you know.
I really want to stress to you guys that any question that you have, don't ever feel bad about asking it, because if you're wondering, then other people are wondering too. They're just not asking.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that with Star Mama being so helpful, I think it's important to ask whatever question you have, not even just about a recipe or whatever, but any ideas, any struggles, anything, you know, we have a lot of people in this community who can tell you maybe what they've learned over the years, right?
Oh, Bell Pepper, you haven't been blocked. I can see you. You said I have been blocked, but you haven't. We can see you in the chat. You're not blocked. Uh-uh. I think it dropped her off of live stream or something. She thinks she's been blocked, but I can see her posting in the chat, so she's not blocked. Yeah, we see you. You're fine. Mm-hmm. And guys, you can make a lot of potato salad pretty cheap. You know, there's so many things, and next weekend, I wanted to try to do a couple of lives if I could. And then maybe load some videos on the side, maybe of what I cook through the week, like make some macaroni and cheese or make a quiche and show you that. And then you've got those videos, even though I'm not doing it live, but add some extra videos in there other than the ones I do live. So it gives you something else. They're still recorded and you can still see, and you know, watch me do them.
Once you're able to post too, mm-hmm. I think it'd be helpful if you did like a grocery list for different meals, you know?
Oh, I plan to do that. Yes, that's one thing I did want to do. Absolutely. Yeah, I do want to do that. So people know, you know. But, you know, like with that quiche, actually, other than getting, you know, buying a package of the deep dish frozen pie shells, you can, in which I thought making a quiche and making a pie, using the other pie shell to show you how to do both things, you're not going to, for a lot of that stuff, most of that stuff you're going to have, just like with the veggies you put in it, your main things is your eggs and your milk or your cream, you know, that you're going to beat up. But the different kinds of meat, you could have like a little bit of bacon. You could have leftover sausage patties or something from breakfast, or you could have some leftover bacon you can crumble up, leftover ham. You could have a little bit of Spam you could cut up and put in there. I mean, there's just so many different, and you can use all kinds of like leftover vegetables. So you've got a little bit of asparagus or, I mean, just different things. A few mushrooms you want to get used up that you had, or a little bit of green pepper, a little bit of onion, you know, and cheese, you can put all kinds of just things in there and get them used up. And it tastes good. It's really not that complicated at all.
I fixed just scrambled eggs, green pepper, onion, garlic, of course,
mm-hmm.
tomato. What else? I did put I put a little touch of ginger in.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why.
Tomatoes are good in quiche and in eggs. It is good. Yes. And yeah, and I love mushrooms too. I think you can.
I loaded it full of mushrooms,
mm-hmm.
fried in butter. And I just heated up a large, for each serving, one large tortilla shell, mm-hmm. a soft shell.
Right.
Put it in kind of like a bowl, and then a few. Have you seen these little round Tostitos, the chips?
Yes.
The round ones?
Yes, the small ones. Yes, I have.
Uh-huh. A few round ones on the side, you know, like a little hard shell kind of thing. And mm-hmm. salsa on those chips. And then sprinkled taco cheese on top. The prettiest little breakfast, let me tell you. It's good for feeding teenagers because eggs are so inexpensive.
Yeah, right now they're you know, they are talking about them getting really high. I hope not, but they are talking about them because I'm paying right now for the 18 count of the extra large. They're right at $4 for that, for 18 eggs. And they told me at the store there's a good possibility by December there'll be a dollar a piece for eggs. I'm just
You're
saying.
Kidding.
Oh, I'm not kidding.
Oh.
I'm not kidding. But you can stretch, you know, your eggs by using a little extra milk, you know, half and half, yes. in them when you're making scrambled eggs, and putting, you know, a little bit of veggies or even cheese, and adding, you can add other things to stretch them. You can do that.
And they are still the perfect protein.
Yes. They are. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm going to do stuffed bell peppers too. That's going to be one thing.
Oh, good. That'll be fun.
Mm-hmm. But my gosh, the things you can do with such a one package of chicken and one package of a 3-pound package of ground beef, I can stretch it and make 2 to 3 meals out of that one package of ground beef. I'm just telling you, you can. And you could easily feed 4 to 5 people at each meal. You can just do it. Yeah, you can. You have to do things sometimes that, and you know, some people don't like some people like a lot of meat. Some people don't care if you have a lot of meat things, but if you have to stretch things, you have to stretch it, right?
Exactly.
If it's a matter of survival and having enough to feed your family, that's what you do. That's what my grandmother said. This is what you do when and you need to feed your family.
Mm-hmm. If you can keep your food bill down, then that keeps your stress levels down too.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. And, you know, kids are kind of spoiled nowadays. They are used to having we used to just eat what was put on the table. And I can't think of anything actually that I don't like. I'll even eat turnips. I eat greens. I eat everything. I really can't think of anything that I won't eat. Even liver and onions and stuff like that. I don't mind that at all. But that's what we ate, you know, at home. And nowadays, some kids, they just refuse to eat, or they think they're privy to, well, or they'll tell them, I'm not eating that, you know. I hear that all the time. I don't want that. I want chicken nuggets. I want McDonald's. I want this, you know, or I want, you know, different places, and you can't afford that necessarily all the time, you know.
I think my generation of moms are the guilty ones for that. I wasn't that way. You know, we served dinner and the kids were allowed to swap food with each other, but they pretty much, I never said they had to clean their plate ever, but they pretty much, you know, I see kids nowadays who absolutely refuse to eat certain things. Mm-hmm. So then their parents are making them whatever it is that they'll agree to eat. And I just think, huh? Yeah. What? You know?
Right.
It's almost like we raised a generation, I think. I don't know.
Well, kids, you know, people do have a tendency to. Well, and also a lot of parents are very busy with jobs and careers, so they don't cook at home a lot. So kids get used to eating out. They do.
That's what I was just going to say, is that I think with the public schools, because, you know, it didn't used to be that your kids depended on the public schools for food.
Right.
It used to be that mom packed a lunch, or, you know, they might have hot lunch on whatever days of the week or something, but they didn't have breakfast. They didn't have dinner, you know, or the afternoon stuff or whatever.
Yeah.
It was lunch. And a lot of times kids preferred to take a packed lunch from home. Well, now it seems like, you know, they can have breakfast at school. They can have lunch at school. They can have whatever.
They give them snacks too. Yes, they do. Yeah.
And then when they get home, you know, the parents are tired. They're working. They're in traffic for too long or whatever. The kids are hungry. And pretty much, plus we didn't have microwaves either. I didn't get a microwave.
Oh, I didn't have one either. Nope.
So that makes a big difference too.
It does.
Right. I think the habit right now is to go ahead and, you know, fix something fast. Instead of, you know, planning out, okay, what time's dinner and what are we going to, you know.
You know, I even sent, my kids had a thermos in their lunchbox where I sent soup even in there for them, you know. Yep. They wanted soup in there, especially in the wintertime. Yeah.
And that was actually a standard thing in the lunchboxes.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't anything, you know, exceptional. That was a standard thing, was where's your thermos? What are you going to put your hot in, you know?
I can remember my mom making fried bologna sandwiches, peanut butter and jelly, things like that that we could take in our lunch. She wouldn't let us take bologna if it wasn't cooked. She made sure she cooked it. And, you know, she made us sandwiches with that. But if I went home for lunch, she might have tuna salad for me she'd put it in a tomato, you know?
Yeah.
And I mean, those are the kind of things we ate. We just had tuna salad and I thought it was great. And anytime I have leftover ham, you know, like from Thanksgiving or Christmas, I will take that ham off as close as I can get it to that bone. And you can make some really good ham salad. You can take and grind that ham up just in a food processor and put some relish with it and mayonnaise and salt and pepper and season that up. And you've got ham salad sandwiches. And that's something else you can stretch. Can do that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And you can use that that ham bone to make ham and beans with too, and get a pan of, but see, that's the problem. Kids don't eat those kind of things. They don't. They go, ooh, beans. Who wants to eat beans, you know, and stuff? Well,
kids are.
I did, you know.
Kids are doing the carbohydrate thing.
Yes.
You know, they have pizza. I think Christopher Watt's answer about what his wife typically fixed is probably pretty normal for the American diet for kids.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and Tabitha said on here, you can freeze eggs by cracking and freezing them in ice cube trays. You put the eggs in the ice cube trays and freeze them. I did not know that. Thank you. And I did all about that. I didn't know that. Yeah, that's nice to know. Wow. That's good to know.
Why did your mother fry the bologna?
Because she thought, she said it was a processed meat, and she's afraid to send it to school in her lunches. She thought it would go bad if it wasn't cooked. Yeah. A lot of people, but see, I look back in Missouri, and a lot of people, that's the way we ate them back there. And they were very good. You just took and you made a little slits so they don't curl up and just fry them, you know. And she put mustard on it, she didn't really put cheese or anything. She just put a little bit of mustard on some bread and put those two pieces of the fried bologna on there. And now I like tomatoes on mine and lettuce and tomato on mine, but, you know, I still eat them.
I used to fry up bologna too. And I thought everybody did, but
yeah.
No.
And actually, I can eat tomato sandwiches too. I can put a fresh homegrown tomato on mayonnaise and put it on bread and eat it. Those are so good. I love fresh tomatoes. I just do. They may say it's a fruit, but I don't care. Tastes like something that makes a good sandwich to me. And actually, people take and mix. Now, my grandkids like peanut butter and honey more than they like peanut butter and jelly. But back when I was growing up, a lot of people were skeptical of honey because people seemed to react to honey. I don't know why. They just were. So if you ate it, you got a little bit on a biscuit or something. We very rarely had it, peanut butter and honey sandwiches. But
honey is great for allergies.
Yeah, it is. But the thing people need to realize, you need to buy your honey wherever the area you live in, like the state or where, because different bees have different pollen in different states. And you can have a reaction to it, maybe just a different pollen that the bees are using when they're making their honey. That I do know.
Well, if I go between two different areas, and when I arrive, I get homegrown honey.
Yeah. But when I lived in the country, guys, I had so much fun. And it was hard work, but I was proud. I put up all kinds of canned green beans. I canned green beans. I froze corn. I froze peas. I made vegetable soup and canned it. You know, I put canned meat up when we had it, got a good buy on stuff. I mean, I made jelly. I went cook. I went actually, we would go out and pick elderberries. We had all kinds of elderberries and we'd bring them in and I would make elderberry juice and I would make an elderberry jelly. And elderberries are really good for you. We didn't know it back then, but they are really good for you. And I would make elderberry jelly and even give it to people for Christmas and stuff. And I had my own chickens. I had my own eggs. You know, we had potatoes, our own onion. We take the onions and we take my old pantyhose and we'd hang them up in the onions up in those old pantyhose down in the storage bin where we had like a storage place, like a storm shelter. And we had a big potato bin. We just put the potatoes in for the whole winter. And then we hung those old pantyhose. We took and put those onions in there and hung them up. And they would keep all winter. They might sprout a little bit, but you could still use them, you know. And I froze greens. Yeah, we just did. I put up frozen strawberries for I made strawberry preserve and I put some up for strawberry shortcake and stuff through the winter months. I mean, that's what we did. We spent a lot of time doing that, those kind of things. And I would sell, I milked a cow. Y'all can believe that. I sure did. And I sold that cow's milk. She was an old Jersey and we only needed a couple of gallons and I'd let the calf have what I did, want, or somebody wanted some. I need to sell a couple of gallons. I sold it. I sold my eggs that helped pay for their feet and stuff, because that's what you did then. I learned to cook on a wood stove. You can be raised in the city all your life and learn how to survive when you have to. You really can. On wood heat, wood stoves, yeah. You can do it. I'm just telling you. You can do it. Yeah, pantyhose. Good for me. We had a lot of, I always kept my old pantyhose, and my ex-father-in-law, he would say, yeah, don't throw those pantyhose away. We can hang those onions in them.
You sound like an all-out country girl.
Well, I wasn't. I was raised in the city, but the thing about it is I had grandparents that lived in the country, so I was introduced to that way of life, and my first husband and all, they thought, they said, she'll never be able to milk a cow. She'll never be able to do a garden. She'll never be able to cook on a wood stove and do, you know, I proved every one of them wrong. And they just couldn't believe that I did do it. And I didn't have anybody. I run my own tiller out there in the garden. I mound my own potato mounds. And I mean, I did. It's a lot of work, but, you know, it sure tastes good in the wintertime when you've got that to eat. You don't have to worry about, you know, if you're going to run out of food and stuff because you put that up. And yeah, we did eat squirrel and rabbits. We sure did then, because that's what you did. You sure
yeah,
did.
Yeah, you were saying that the other day. I don't get into the squirrel thing.
Yeah. A lot of people, but I mean, that's just something you did. And even my dad would go quail hunting and we would eat, we had fried quail and it's good. There are things that people did years ago, but it kept their food bills down, and that's the way they survived, you know.
Right. So, and that's what it's about, because I do think the prices are going to keep climbing.
Mm-hmm. And it's always good to know that stuff, because if things really get bad, yeah, it's just.
And, you know, the whole idea of food security, it doesn't have to be even, you know, you don't have to memorize a bunch of recipes, or you don't have to become, you know, the gourmet chef or anything. Mm-hmm. It's just trying to kind of change your habits a little bit so that you can conserve food money whenever you can.
Right. Oh, thank you, Bill. Thank you, Bill Pepper. That's very kind of you. I'm glad that, you know, it brought back memories, because those are the memories I have. And I tell my children, you know, my older kids remember, not my younger ones. And they, you know, the one thing I can actually say, every one of my kids can cook. Every one of them. They all cook. Every one of them. They sure do.
Well, and I think it had to do with us not having microwaves right away, too.
Yes, I do. I think that, too. Yeah. And they weren't afraid to get out and help in the gardens. They weren't afraid to get out and, you know, put potatoes up and, you know, go pick green beans for me to can and stuff, because it's a lot of work. And you put in a full day after you... Yeah, you're trying to cook a meal, and you're doing laundry, and you're milking cows, you're feeding chickens, you're taking care of slopping hogs, and you're out working in a garden, and you're putting stuff up. It's a full day, and then you come in and you want to cook meals. And we didn't have crock pots and stuff then either. You either put it in the oven or you cooked it on top of the stove. You didn't have all this equipment they've got now. That's for sure. You just didn't. Nothing like that. Yeah, I plan to do that, Mrs. Ben, but you don't get a community post until you get 1,000 subs. Then I can post recipes and stuff on there. I can do that, but I have to have that 1,000 subs. That's one thing, because they don't open that community post up till you can. That's, I guess, it's considered get 1,000 subs, and that's a reward for that, I guess, to say you have your community post.
You'll have 1,000 subs before you know it. You will.
Yeah, I hope so. That'd be nice. Oh, and we even would go out and pick apples off the apple trees. Even, I don't care even if some of them got, the worms did get in some of them, but you know what? My grandmother showed me how to, you cut those areas out where the worms might have made a little place on them. And she made applesauce. She made apple pie. She made fried pie. She made apple jelly. She made apple juice, because that's what you did. You didn't throw anything out. You tried to use anything you could that you could salvage.
My grandpa used to love apple butter.
Yes, apple butter. I love apple butter. It's good. It really is. And I will show you all how to make biscuits too. It's real easy.
Good.
All you have to have is self-rising flour and a little bit of, I prefer Crisco or lard, and some buttermilk, and you're set. Nothing to it. Really isn't. And people, like I said, the worst thing people do, it's just like with meatloaf. I said, don't overwork your meat, because it makes them, it's just better if you just blend it together and you put it in there and let it cook, because to me, it makes them tough. And the same way with biscuits and stuff, if you work your dough once you put that flour in your cake, if you keep beating it, you're going to have tough things, tough pancakes, waffles, anything like that. I'm just telling you, I've learned that. And also, like I said, the best thing I can tell you on, if you're using exact, I always sift my flour though, when I'm making anything, I sift it and then I measure it if I'm using measurements. And if I'm not, I still sift the flour. I just do. You get, and you can make, and people, you know, a lot of people will serve breakfast for supper. You can make a big thing of biscuits and make a big thing of sausage gravy and scramble or make fried potatoes. That's all you would need is a pan of biscuits, sausage gravy, and some fried potatoes. And people would have plenty to eat. They would get full on that. Oh, and I have a tea cake recipe too. This is Ben. I do have one. I actually got that from my deceased husband's mother. I do have a recipe and they're good. She's really got a good one. What time is supper at my house? Actually, my daughter is cooking dinner today because she knew I was going to be busy with this. So I have no idea. And she's really a good cook. And I enjoy sitting back and eating the things that she cooks, because it's a break for me. And, you know, it's kind of nice, you know, when you got somebody else that is cooking. And another thing that's really, I am very bad about, after I have cooked a big meal, I can't eat. When I cook Thanksgiving or Christmas, hold on a minute. We got somebody at the door, of course. Okay. Guys, hey guys. No, actually, it's firecrackers. This is going to be exciting. But anyway, I forget where I was at. I remember telling you about the sausage gravy and stuff. When my daughter cooks, I enjoy that, you know, because a lot of times when I make the big meal, I can't eat. So now I need a Thanksgiving or Christmas dinner. After I've cooked that stuff all day, I've enjoyed it, but I just have to sit down and I've tasted on it all day. And, you know, you make dressing and you're, and tasting on everything and your desserts and stuff, you just lose interest in it. I don't know. I do anyway. I don't know if that makes sense to people or not, but a lot of cooks, my grandmother, she wouldn't sit down and eat after she cooked a big meal either. She just sat there kind of picking things. But we scarfed it down, of course. It was good to us. What is the name of my channel? It's just Star Mama. And Miss Mintz posted the link several times, so you'll be able to find it. And I appreciate all you subbing to me. That's going to give me the initiative to even go harder and stronger at this. It really is. I appreciate it, guys. I really do. And I love to. I love to teach people how to cook. I love to do home cooking. But most people nowadays are not interested in it. Actually, there's very few people that even want to bother with it.
I'm sitting here talking and I looked and I thought, well, I can hear Paula. Why does it say muted? And I looked down and I'm muted while I'm talking.
Yeah, I'm I couldn't hear you. I thought you either had a call or something.
No, yeah, I'm sitting here talking. I'm like, yeah, I just put the link in again. It's right there.
Yeah, you were muted.
And then you're like, yeah, I think I'm gonna put the link in. And I'm thinking, I just said that. Oh my goodness. I did just grab my phone and it's after 6 o'clock. I think if everyone's okay with this, I think we should hop off because this is a holiday weekend.
Okay. Yeah, I don't have any problem.
Okay. And then, so you're able now to fill out whatever, and then it'll be like a day or whatever for you to be able to actually do a live.
Right. I can go in there now and do whatever it is at YouTube. They say once you have your 50 subs, then you notify them that you want to start a YouTube, you want to go live on your YouTube channel, and they you can't be in trouble with YouTube in the last 90 days. So I know I haven't been in trouble, so that might be a problem.
And then if you want, just email me on whenever you want to do your live, and then I'll do a StreamYard announcement thing.
Okay.
And then that way, like I said before, we could meet up and then everyone go there.
Okay, that's fine.
I mean, on this channel, we've got 4,200 subs. So that, that, you know, there might be a lot of people who are not as much into true crime as they are cooking, you know?
And yes, Tabitha, I will show you all how to do pies. I will do that. I plan to do it all. I really do. That's why I want to do some stuff through the week that I'm actually cooking here and record those videos. And then I can do some lives, you know, also. Yep. But there's some I can just go ahead and record because it's hard to go live all. It's going to be hard to go live all the time, but I can record things and then y'all can go back and look at those too.
We could do it like Justin does. He'll do a record, he'll do a video, and then he'll do a live, and then he'll play his video.
Right. Yeah. Well, that's true too. They then go in there and look at those, but they've always got them to go back. Either way, they've got plenty to go back and look at. Yeah.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Exactly. Very cool. Well, I'm so glad that you're doing that with the uploads. Oh my gosh.
I'm glad too now because I had no idea that so many people would be interested in it. That makes me feel good, actually.
You just have the knack, you know. Not everybody is talented in the kitchen and talented with speaking.
Well, I learned that from how to speak from coming on here because I hadn't done any before that other than that little thing exposing, you know, those threatening emails I got, and that was the extent of that. And that's not really what I call talking and discussing cases, you know. This is when you get into true crime and you get into discussing cases, you get in depth in these things, you know.
Right.
And to be able to talk about it and you have to be able to listen to people's opinions, you know. And like that one guy we had come in, remember that one guy that jumped up on the panel and we cornered him. He didn't know what to do, did he?
I think it was, when was Cece's birthday? Well, what does that matter?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And we were like, well, it matters.
And even, wasn't he the one that said it happened in 2019? He didn't even know it was in 2018. He had the wrong year. Everything was wrong, yeah.
Yeah.
And I remember that the record said that he was sitting over. He said, I was sitting over laughing my butt off watching y'all because he didn't know what to do. You both had him sidetracked. I mean, we were just throwing facts at him, right? And it wasn't stupid things. You know, he kept wanting to go into the defense mode, and I kept bringing up, check the knives. You know, we kept throwing stuff at him. Yeah.
Anyway. Another distraction, and that's what they do.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah. And we think we knew who that was. Somebody that had a YouTube channel or something and come back. And
I know who he was hooked to and who he was hooked to. One of the worst scumbag attackers of all.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. Yeah. What's but anyway, you all have a nice 4th of July and enjoy your family. I know a lot of people, since the 4th of July is on Monday, a lot of people have Tuesday off too. They're not going back to work till Wednesday because it's a paid holiday. So, yeah.
And definitely don't let the weekend go by without having s'mores.
Right. Yes. That's have fun. Just have fun and enjoy your family, too, because that's what it's about. Loving your family.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. And I'm going to say, everybody, thank you for being here and be safe. Be healthy. Don't forget to take your vitamin D. And always know that you are loved. And now I'm going to find our song, I think. My new favorite. Notice I haven't played that other one.
Yeah, I noticed that. Yeah.
Because I just love this song. I love it. It is so, it's just perfect. And some of the words are just so target, you know?
Yes.
people listening. No, people hearing without listening.
Right.
That's the phrase that is most notable.
Yeah, and you know, now that we got our pictures out there, they can't keep saying they want to keep coming at us and saying we're old hags. Well, okay, but I don't think we look like old hags. So try it a different way. We're old, shriveled up, old wrinkled women. Okay, good one. Just keep coming at it. You know, y'all can see now that we're not, so you can't go there anymore. You know,
the only person that looks ugly when they're saying stuff like that are them.
Yeah, it's just, I just can't believe they go there and say things like that. They have never seen anybody, and they want to be so judgmental about what people appear, what their appearances are.
It's abuse. They're not being judgmental. They're being abusive. They're being scumbags. You do not talk to another human being that way, ever.
Yeah, and AD paid you a lot of compliments about your pictures and stuff. So, yeah, I mean, see,
It was hard to hear back and forth. And as he's saying that, I'm like, okay, what did he just say? And then, so I was kind of like on a delay, is the word.
Yeah, it is a little delayed, yes.
Mm-hmm. But then I was registering what he had just said. I'm like, oh, that was nice. But then he was, you know, it was hard to.
Yeah.
I'm definitely going to get that Chrome thing figured out before I go up there again. I'm not going to go through that again.
Okay, well, make sure you let us know, though, when you're going to go over there and play that video of Cindy's, because I'm sure a lot of us would like to be there for support, you know.
Yes, yes, I'll definitely let you know. And, yeah, and I appreciate your kind words, too, because that was kind of nerve-wracking.
I know. Well, that's what I felt about doing these videos, you know, and stuff. It's different, you know, when you go on somebody else's, and like you were, you know, it's different, isn't it? It's just a different feeling, you know.
It's like, you know, I like driving the car. I'm cool with being the passenger as long as my computer's looking. Can you hear me okay?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, so I just got a battery. Let me plug it in real quick. I got a warning thing. I like driving. You know, anytime, especially on a long trip or something, I really like driving. I like being the passenger too, as long as the driver is like really highly skilled and I don't have to worry, you know, then that, like, I don't want to have to sit there and watch or help or anything.
Right.
So it's kind of the same thing when you hop up on somebody else's panel. It's like, it's weird, you know, you don't want to stay too long. You don't want to say too much. You don't want to.
Right.
That's goofy. You can't, you know what I mean? It's weird. Right.
Yes, Tabitha, I will show you how to do, stuffed green peppers, and that's something else. You can use a little bit of ground beef, and you can put extra cooked rice in there and stuff, and you can stretch it. That's something else you can stretch. It sure is. All right, guys.
I'm trying to get back to the right screen here. Here we go. I have a feeling the song's going to start in 2 seconds, so thanks again, everyone, for being here.
Yeah, have a good holiday, everybody, and be safe and enjoy your family.
4th of July, and remember, if you have escaped abuse or if you have survived domestic violence or child abuse,
brain health expert. And the first thing I
definitely
tell new clients,
I want you to be sure
is this.
To celebrate. Celebrate your own independence.
Please welcome Disturb.
Yeah. All right. Good night, everybody. Goodbye.
Good night. Congratulations. I'll say it really, really quick. No, I won't. Because he started singing. I'll say it anyway. If you have survived domestic violence, if you have survived child abuse, on this July 4th Independence Day holiday weekend, I want you to honor yourself. Honor your bravery.
That was planted
in your strength. In my brain. You know, a lot of people do not escape. A lot of people are not able to find the strength to protect themselves or to protect their children. So if you're a survivor, if you're kicking butt, and I know it's hard, it's not easy. But if you're making it through, if you made it out, then I want you to celebrate Independence Day, your personal independence.
By the flash of a neon light, it's midnight, and touch the sound of silence. And in the naked light I saw 10,000 people, maybe more. People talking without speaking, people hearing without listening, people writing songs and voices never shared. No one dared disturb the sound of silence. For said I, you do not know. Silence like a cancer grows. Hear my words and I might teach you. Take my arms and I might reach you. But my words like silent raindrops fall.
Final curtain, my friend.